promising a fitting response if attacked by India. Now, that comes a week after Pakistan-based armed group claimed responsibility for a suicide car bomb attack that killed 40 Indian paramilitary troops. New Delhi accuses Pakistan's intelligence agency of being behind the attack, a charge Islamabad has denied. Kamal Haider reports from Pakistani-administered Kashmir.
Muzaffarabad is the capital of Pakistani-administered Kashmir. It's another busy day and people are going about their daily lives. However, they are apprehensive about what may happen within the next few days and weeks as two armies, that of India and Pakistan, stand across a line of divide separating Indian-administered Kashmir from the Pakistani side. The Pakistani Prime Minister has already responded to the Indian threats by saying that Pakistan wants to talk about peace and dialogue and wants to discuss everything, including terrorism and the future of the disputed territory of Kashmir. The Pakistani military spokesman has also been speaking on national television, saying that while the Pakistani media has operated in a sensible way, the Indian media on the other side is warmongering and building a hype. He said that Pakistan wants peace for the security of the whole region, but that the country is prepared for war. And he also warned that if the Indians are planning a surprise against Pakistan, then he said, then you should be ready for the Pakistani surprise as well. He said the whole nation stood together and did not want India to get the message that the message of peace was also a message of weakness.
Well, earlier I spoke with Shashi Tharoor, an Indian opposition MP from the Congress Party. He's a former UN Undersecretary General for Communications and Public Information. He says the Indian government's pandering to Pakistan prevents it from what he thinks should be a tougher response to last week's attack.
Well, I'd like them to be doing things we can't talk about, frankly. I'd like them to be exacting a certain amount of retribution. We know who the culprits are. They've been running around on the loose in Pakistan for some years, and we seem to be, unfortunately, confined to sort of fulminating about them. The sad thing is they enjoy the patronage and the protection and apparently the arms and the training of the Pakistani military, and that's something that really gets the goat of many, many Indians. So these are things that worry us very seriously. It's a dangerous and irresponsible thing to do. And obviously, the country to that degree is pretty united on this.
And we'll have more of that interview with Shashi Tharoor in the next hour. That's at 18 GMT.